It's Larry here from Xbox Live's Major Nelson. It's the end of November. If you're in the U.S., it's Thanksgiving. If you're in Canada, it was Thanksgiving.
You can do it again. Have another turkey. No one's going to complain.
No one who's going to complain. But Jeff and I are in the studio. It's actually, it's so difficult getting both of us in here. And we looked at each other and realized that our schedules are quiet this week as they tend to be right before the holiday. So let's make work for ourselves.
I couldn't believe it. Speaking of making work for ourselves, I have some grievances with you, Larry.
I'm sorry. Apparently, this is the grievance desk.
This is the airing of grievances. It is the Festivus. They're actually doing it. My mom sent me an article last night that in Fort Lauderdale, surprise, near Del Boca Vista Phase 2, they're doing a full-on Festivus celebration,
right,
including the airing of grievances,
okay,
which so I am now.
You're ready to embrace?
I'm ready to do it.
Okay.
After this will be the feats of strength. So that's a Seinfeld reference for... Yeah, everyone listening to this is old, let's be honest. So,
we have some youngsters.
Do we?
So we've
the fact that you called them youngsters. The kids with their skateboards.
Hold on, what's that? What was that listener? Something okay boomer? Okay, go ahead.
There we go. So, new habit of yours, which is anything that I'm talking about in the office, you're tweeting out in a play-by-play fashion. I'm
anything.
Like, why is my phone
not
absolutely blowing up? And I can't even share coffee maker recommendations.
All I know
people.
Is, so this, what Jeff is referencing, if you follow me on Twitter, at Major Nelson, or Jeff, at Jeff Rubenstein, we were in the office earlier in the week or last week, and one of our coworkers needed a new coffee maker.
This is the role that I was born to play.
Right.
Like when someone says, I would like some advice on fill in the blank. That's what I do.
Right.
That's what gets me excited.
No, not fill in the blank on coffee makers.
Well, especially that.
Right.
But there's other things.
Right.
You know.
There are. There's a handful of things
games,
of which
games
you which you are an expert at.
Couch co-op games.
If you have
support?
The Venn diagram of expertise, you suppose you're on the left. You've got all your things on the left.
Yeah.
Mine's on the right. The shared area is actually toilets, total washlets.
Multiplayer
games on Xbox.
And barbecue.
Barbecue. There's a few other things, but one of the areas that's not in there that I like to excel at, or I think I do, is networking.
I bow to you on networking.
I try to help.
Both in real life and also like Wi-Fi networking.
So you have some grievances. Anyway, you were talking about your coffee, and I just thought I was waiting for the recommendation, and I wanted to tweet that out because you do have.
I did give a recommendation.
Well,
instead, what you did is said, "Oh, now he's talking about this."
Still going,
which was not inaccurate. Once I get rolling, I can't stop.
And the money quote wasn't even related to coffee. It was, who needs a 4-slice toaster? The internet took issue with that.
I guess
those that have more than one child.
Yeah, that was a good point. I guess we take turns on the toaster. It teaches my kid patience.
Right.
She will wait until my bread is
properly
baked
toast.
And then baked again.
So, now you said bread. You didn't say bagel, which concerns me.
Can't get a good bagel out here. Never been a bagel in that toaster because no bagel has been worthy of that.
It's not
toaster.
Able to cross the threshold in your house.
No, I need to have someone.
Well, I thought the audience would enjoy that.
No, it's funny. By the way, what you didn't share was the actual recommendation.
Which is
the least expensive coffee maker you can get, which is my favorite, what I've made this cup of coffee
The rubber
with,
AeroPress.
Which is the AeroPress,
yes.
Made by the people that made the Frisbees, the Aerobies, for some reason.
That's, okay.
Look, what if you invented two things, and one was a Frisbee and one was a coffee maker?
Okay.
I'm sure that person was in a much nicer house than
again,
I do.
Getting back to the Venn diagram, I'm looking at the technology, I'm going, where do these intersect?
People have diverse passions, Larry.
Right, as you and I have proved.
And I use a cheap, like $12 Krups grinder.
Yeah.
And I just grind my coffee.
Yep.
And I threw it in the AeroPress. It's
yes.
done in 4 minutes.
Yep.
And I move on with my day. Then I come and we make podcast magic.
The time that
Everyone's
you've done
up.
Your the 4 minutes there, I've already downed 2 Nespressos. I know that you don't like my Nespresso. He and I have gone for this forever, but because he's a coffee fanatic like you are, and I prefer I like espresso.
Well, here's the thing. The reason, like, in I was reading all about Italian espresso culture because I realized that's a blind spot for me.
Yeah.
And they don't have seats in a lot of Italian coffee shops or very few seats because they don't want you hanging out. You stand, you down your espresso the way you do it, and you move on with your day.
But if
maybe if you're dragging in the afternoon, you have a Coca Light.
Right, Coca Light. That's right.
Yes.
But you have to admit that if you think about the Italian coffee culture, that extends to all parts of my life, right? Like, you always call me the fastest eater, you know? And there's, I mean, I, like, I'm always moving.
I look down and I look back up and it's gone. And I'm like, great, now I have an audience. And then you'll tweet about it. So that brings us full circle.
What else? Do you have any other grievances that we can get out of the way? Yes, there is. No. I know there is.
Well, no, you invited me over for Thanksgiving this year, so that grievance is gone.
Well, no, there is another one, the gaming grievance. Do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, because I actually feel this bad about this.
This is twice now in a month.
Which is weird because I don't do this.
Where you're like, hey, have you done this? And then you show me a video or a clip of something I haven't gotten to in a game yet.
Yeah. A spoiler.
Now, you really spoiled something for, and I'll never let you forget it,
I know.
For Outer Worlds.
Yeah.
Actually, you're forgiven, but I just don't want you to know that.
You want to lord it over my head?
Yeah,
I do.
It's fine. I need these things. And then you did it just yesterday.
With a video
for Star Wars Jedi Force Unleashed. It just happened to be something I was getting to in an hour. And actually, I got a way worse spoiler on YouTube. Mm-hmm. So, you know. You're in the clear. You're on the clear on that one. I'll complain about it, but we're all right.
It was just a little piece, and it was something. By the way, it was Jedi Fallen Order.
Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order.
You said Force Unleashed.
Did I really?
Yes. And the internet's angry right now.
They should be.
This is a much better game
than Force Unleashed. You don't have to lift a Star Destroyer. I don't know. I haven't beaten the game yet, but we should just talk about that. Because we're playing this game.
Yeah, let's. You want to talk about what we're playing? Or you want to talk about the news?
Let's talk about what we're playing.
I mean, really, we just did.
Well, yeah, but I mean, this is. We both came back from London.
We'll talk about that
and,
later.
And like literally, at the airport, we were like downloading.
Yeah, putting the code in to start pushing it to our console.
Exactly. And that was I was so tired when I landed. I still had to load it up and play.
Right.
Star Wars Jedi.
Yeah.
Not Force Unleashed.
Fallen Order. Yes.
Is I think it's the best Star Wars game I've ever played.
It is. I mean, you can get into the
Dark Forces or Shadows of the Empire was fun. But if I was to say, to go back, I don't think any game has encapsulated what it feels like to fight the way a Jedi fights than this game. You're not invincible. Otherwise, there would be no movies. You would just throw your lightsaber and be done. Yet, you can overwhelm, you know, one-on-one just about anybody. What? Tell me.
No, I want to say something, but I don't want to, dear listener, fast forward for a minute and a half because I'm going to have a little bit of a spoiler. So I did unlock one of the, in the skill tree, you can unlock different things, as you know. And I unlocked one where I can pull all the enemies around me to get to me.
Sure.
And then just take them all down.
Oh, it's amazing. Yeah. The pull in and then the sort of gut them with the,
you get visceral, but yeah, that's,
well, it's a lightning sword.
Still more spoilers here. The only issue I have with the game so far.
Go.
Really? Right off the bat, a Jedi doesn't have double jump? Really? You get three quarters of the game before you unlock it.
It's true, but as someone who, likes Metroidvanias, that just comes with the territory. I know. And I think even the plausibility of why he doesn't have these abilities in the beginning.
Right. I mean, they do give it a little
really well done. Yeah. And then there was a very cool mission, which we both did yesterday, I think, that sort of delves into some of that stuff, which I really enjoyed as well. I just really love this game. So I want to actually, I retweeted it just now.
Did you?
I think I'm close to the end game. Where I gotta go, and I just gotta.
Do you want to tell me where you are? Spoilers. Folks.
No, I'm just late in the game. I have all the abilities, at least as far as I know.
Did you get to the area of the map that I showed you, that I sent you?
Yes, I finished that planet.
Okay, so that temple.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's
where you and I are exactly the same place.
Right. And so I get back to the ship, and they're like, okay, they want to send me to one planet again. And then, but then the pilot, Grizz?
Yeah.
Who's very well acted, by the way.
Yeah, who is he? Is that your Uncle Morty? I think he's your Uncle Morty.
He definitely has a bit of, he celebrates Festivus. he mentioned something about, hey, you should go back to this planet Zepho from very early in the game.
Right,
one of the first planets
that's
you go
where I'm
to. And so Mitchie D,
who
may be familiar to some of you guys.
I haven't talked to Mitchie in a while.
He was the writer for Battlefront 2, and he works, I guess he's just very familiar with Star Wars in many ways. Anyway, he says, a big tip for Fallen Order, now that it's been out for a bit, minor location spoiler, but not plot related. Once you get all of Cal's major force abilities, which we have at this point in the game, including that double jump, visit Zepho and explore the optional Venator crash site. It's mentioned when you go there the first time, but you can't get to it. It's home to the best level and narrative design in the entire game.
Okay.
So I'm going to go do that. And there is a lot of value in going back to the planets. Once, as you unlock different abilities, if you go back, there's sort of a training planet.
Yeah.
That begins with a G, I think. Once you go back there, even when you first get your force push, go back there. There's a lot of the stims, the extra stims, which really keep you alive. The way that BD-1 heals you. Even right at the very beginning, directly under where your ship lands, you can go under there. And once you have force push, you can unlock that. There's a little puzzle. But there's at least two or three of the gold boxes. So I have like 7 stims now, which is great. I think there's 10 total in the game. Makes the game a lot easier to have those.
Yeah.
So definitely go back and find some of those boxes and get them, because those are the ones that are labeled secrets, or either those or the things that upgrade your health or your force level.
And the issue I have is you somehow ended up getting the bonus edition, and you have the orange lightsaber.
I don't even use it.
As a Syracuse University, as you can tell.
I know.
And you got the special BD-1 skin. You got the...
Can we talk about BD-1?
Different hilts. You got the golden mantis skin.
Yep. I'm going to say BD-1 is greater than BB-8. I really like BD-1. The way they're able to make like a droid that can't talk...
The personality. No facial,
to have that much personality. He reminds me of like Wally... If Wally had a baby.
Yeah. No, I think BD-1 is up there as one of my favorite droids. And granted, not all the droids are throwing you stims, but the fact that you upgrade yourself and him as you go through the story, and I feel terrible because these may be spoilers. All we have to say is, if you love Star Wars and you love video games, you have to play this game, because it is, as Jeff said, it is one of the best, if not the best Star Wars game. And I know you guys are going to
look, there's plenty of room for debate. I'm not going to say anyone's wrong.
Let's put it this way. It's way better than anything we've had recently.
Oh, for sure.
Okay, let's just leave it at that. Let's leave it that way.
Yeah. Anyway, phenomenal game. Yeah. I love it. Can't wait to play more. Can't wait to finish it over the Thanksgiving break.
Yeah, our friends at Respawn. I'm going to finish it too over Thanksgiving, I think.
Yeah, I might.
You and I are doing it at roughly the same time.
This is good.
I mean, seriously.
As soon as I beat it, I will take a photo of it and send it to you immediately.
That's fine.
Now, actually, the thing that got spoiled for me, I want to know when you get to it, because it seems really cool. And I'll say nothing further.
Okay.
The game's got more coming at you.
Jedi Fallen Order now available. If you're an EA Access member, I believe you get access to it as well. So I've got to double check that.
That's usually the case.
Yeah.
At the very least, there's a discount.
Yep.
Of somewhere in the neighborhood of 10% off. So always good to EA Access.
And Uncle Morty loves to save a 10%.
Oh my God, such a deal. He knows a guy. He knows a guy at EA.
Such a deal. Don't do anything until I talk to you.
You know what else came out that I haven't had a chance to play it, but I've been watching a lot this week. Is Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition.
Yes. I did the interview with Shannon at XO.
Yes, you did. Part of the World's Edge studio that is going to be making Age 4. Very excited. So some streamers have really jumped onto H2DE this week. Watched Lyric.
Lyric is one of the streamers.
Lyric is one of the biggest variety streamers in the world, but he had a tremendous audience watching him play through some of the campaigns. And I was going through the achievements at that point just to see how much is in that game.
How much is in that game?
I think it's 1,300 gamer score. There's like 15 or more campaigns in the game. I'm someone who's not very good at RTSs playing against somebody. Like if I play online, I'll get whooped.
What is this?
What?
How can this be?
What?
I'm comparing achievements. Look at the top. How do you have more achievements in Star Wars than I do?
Because I'm very thorough. All right, so there's a point. We're going back. Okay. Working backwards here. After you get, after you're on that planet that we just did, once you sort of get, you get your final ability, which is a really cool attack, they sort of throw you out into an area with a bunch of cannon fodder.
Oh, I didn't get this one. Collect all chests and secrets.
I didn't get that one. That one's the hard one to get. That one and all the seedlings, apparently. I would love to 1K this game, but I just don't think I'm going to be
able to. I don't really want to say much more, so I don't know if this is a secret achievement. So
okay.
I'll leave it at
that. That's fair. Anyway, there's some points where towards the end, a lot of the ones that say deflect, you know, X amount of bolts, or do perfect parries, or the sort of the perfectly timed dodge.
I don't parry enough.
You have to.
I know you have to, but I tend to just do a lot of rolling and.
So if you just do the dodge with just hitting B button.
Yeah.
Which is it? There's an ability that you can unlock that slows time down. And
right.
Gives you a bit of force down when you do it right. And for most enemies, that just that B, and then even the things they say, because you seem like you're moving in real time, but to the
right.
to the stormtroopers, they think you're moving super fast. Like, how did you do that?
Right.
Some of the dialogue, by the way,
very good.
The troopers are fun to listen to. Like yeah. Sometimes you'll sneak up on them, and I'll just listen to them for a little bit, and then you need to send them packing. But
yeah, see, I have one you didn't unlock.
Oh,
defeated
really?
Each type of bounty hunter.
What? Yeah. How did I not?
It says right there. You did not. It's still locked. So
well then. I'm going to have to.
Anyway.
All right.
But you have way more unlocked than I do. Either way.
Either way. Yeah.
Star Wars.
My goal is to have at least 6 or 7.
And the Star Wars movie comes out next month, which I have.
Just a couple weeks.
You and I are going to go to the screening, right?
Yeah,
I've got our tickets at Cinerama.
Yep.
I've seen every single Star Wars at Cinerama, even those that were re-released when I didn't live out here.
Oh, nice. So. Even including like Solo and.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I never saw that one, actually. And then I've been watching Mandalorian as well.
This is
like a good Star Wars couple of months.
So here's the tip. Disney Plus out now in the US. It's coming elsewhere soon. I don't actually know when. But on the Xbox One, you can watch all of the Star Wars films. Xbox One S, Xbox One X. You can watch them all in 4K. And it is the only, I think on Xbox, I think PlayStation has as well, and Apple TV. I think those are the only three places you can watch those in 4K. You'll see them elsewhere.
With Apple TV, I think you need a specific type of Apple TV.
Right.
Anyway,
right.
if you got an Xbox One S or X,
right,
you're set.
Right.
You're
so,
set.
But
and
they look
so
in 4K. Oh. You can see like the very first one. You can see the dirt on Darth Vader's cape and just all sorts of crazy. They just look so good. Best way and place to experience them.
Indeed.
So Star Wars, lots of Star Wars coming up, including the movie. So Mandalorian's great. And I'll just give you, again, here's a spoiler. If you have not watched The Mandalorian, fast forward 60 seconds because I'm going to say it in 3, 2, 1.
Wait. I've only watched one episode. So don't spoil a darn thing for me. Don't do it, Larry. Don't do it.
Okay, I can't.
He's going to do it. He wants to do it.
I can't say it now.
This is real spoiler.
Can't say it.
No, you can't.
Let's talk about what happened at the end because I can't remember.
Of the first episode?
Yeah.
Baby Yoda.
Okay, Baby Yoda. That's what I was going to say, Baby Yoda.
Yes.
That's all I'm going to say.
Yes.
So.
Adorable.
Adorable. Adorbs, as your wife would say?
Maybe. It is the Hello Kitty of Jim Henson creatures or whatever.
And did you read the Werner Herzog quote?
I did, but is that real?
Yes. I saw him say it. He said it on a red carpet.
Go ahead and let everyone know.
Essentially, Werner Herzog, who plays the, and I don't remember the character's name, he's the one who issues the bounty. He was with the stormtroopers around him to go get the Baby Yoda. This is filled with spoilers.
I'm sorry.
He said that the original, I guess they used a puppet on set, and he's a famed director.
Yeah.
He's been a director for a few decades now. He said, now he's a little bit of an actor, he said that they were going to digitally put in Yoda, and he said, he called them cowards. He said,
wow.
No, keep that in there. Keep the original. And he apparently was like talking to the puppet on set like it's real. Crazy stuff.
I didn't realize Werner Herzog was a film director. I thought he was like a scientist.
Oh, stop it.
I thought he was a scientist.
You're kidding.
Maybe I'm thinking of like.
You've never seen the Fitzcarraldo?
Huh?
Look it up. I'm sure you're looking at his Wikipedia page.
I am right now. You're like a director. I thought he was like some like philosopher, poet, ninja.
No, well, he is, but he's also a director.
Okay, fair enough.
So,
I don't think I've ever seen any of his movies. I'm not a man of taste. You're really not happy about this.
No, I'm most displeased.
All right,
most
I'm looking
displeased.
Up his IMDb. I've never seen any of these movies.
Anyway, anyway, all right, enough about Star Wars, enough Mandalorian, enough spoilers for Pete's sakes. You seem to be really taken aback with what you're reading right now.
I have never heard of any of these movies.
Tick through a few of them.
Not a one.
Is the Fitzcarraldo on there?
Oh, Jack Reacher.
Yeah.
I didn't see it, though.
Okay.
At least I've heard of that one, though.
Okay.
Bad Lieutenant?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Fair enough.
Go back to the 70s.
Oh, my God. I'm only in, like, 2003. This guy does a lot of movies.
He's busy. He's pro. One would say prolific.
Yeah. Cobra Verde. Sounds cool. I don't know. Man, I'm thinking of salsa bread. I'm very hungry. He was in an episode of The Simpsons. That's how I know him. And The Mandalorian. That's all that really matters. Anyways. Thank you, Werner Herzog, for Baby Yoda. Did the business on that one.
All right, let's, you know, we talked about what we're playing.
You want to talk about what we're buying?
What are we buying? Because it's sale time.
It is sale time. As you're hearing this,
Black Friday sales.
We are in the middle of the biggest Black Friday sale. And it goes through December 2nd.
Right.
So you've probably still got at least a couple of days.
Who knows when you're listening to this? If you're listening to this in January, then you missed the boat.
Yeah, but I think you realize that.
But then if you missed it, then you should be following me on Twitter, checking out my blog or Xbox Wire, because that's where all the news is.
Yeah, it's true. And we redesigned Xbox Wire just for you.
Yeah.
So there is a tremendous... So if you go over to majornelson.com, and we'll link to it in the show notes... your team has spent a lot of time building this like sortable list of games sorted by, you can sort by what's the biggest discount. It is kind of crazy exactly how big some of these sales are. So right now I'm just bringing up what is the biggest discounts.
And you can sort by that over there.
Deus Ex, Mankind Divided.
Good game.
Great game.
You never played that, did you?
I beat it.
I think I did too, yeah.
Yeah. It's like 85% off if you have Xbox Live Gold.
What?
Let's see. There's Lara Croft and the Temple of Osiris. That was good. 85%. There's a lot of games in here that are like 75 to 85% off. Project Cars 2, Guacamelee 2. Highly recommend
that
game.
You love that. I know you love your Guacamelees.
It is it's a Xbox Play Anywhere game. So
it
I've
is.
Been playing it mostly on PC. Anthem is 80% off. Battlefield 1, 80% off. FIFA... The Journey Trilogy, that is like, I'm assuming that's like the last three FIFAs, 80% off. Dirt 4, Life is Strange,
look,
all
we,
of these games, 80% off.
We're not going to turn this into the podcast where Jeff reads you all of the deals. You can go over there
I'm
and
just
read
reading
the
some of the biggest right. ones. There's so many, Far Cry 5, 75%.
There's
off.
Hundreds.
There really is hundreds.
Yeah.
Anyway, you can sort it alphabetically.
By deal.
Whatever you like.
Percent off.
If they're Xbox One X enhanced.
Right.
There's a lot of stuff.
This
here,
is just
we'll
a little bit of the
it.
Service we provide to you, the gamer, the Xbox gamer.
And you should be lauded for it, Larry.
Well, we just try to do what we can do.
We do what we can. Let's see. Games of Gold were just announced for December. The one I'm most excited about is Jurassic World Evolution, which is like a park builder type of game. And that'll be available on December 16th.
That's the one where I went down and interviewed Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah.
Where we had dueling Jeff Goldblums.
That was...
Because I had my glasses on.
We'll have to link back to that story. We'll have to find that. That was actually really entertaining. Also, Castlevania. There's a Castlevania game from backward compatible from Xbox 360, Toy Story 3, and Insane Robots.
The Jurassic game. You remember what I did in that game?
Yeah, what?
So we have a friend of ours who's the producer, the exec producer of Inside Xbox, Ryan.
Yeah.
Last name. His gamer tag is Triton True. I play with him quite frequently. He inexplicably hates dinosaurs.
Did he have a bad experience?
He just hates them. He gets angry to the point of, on my phone, I use a dinosaur as his profile picture, which angers him. And I named his last name is Trite. In the game, I named all of the dinosaurs. You can personalize them. Tritosaurus.
Yeah, you had to do it. I am looking for, we'll have to find this because it was on This Week on Xbox. March 30th, 2018 is when you interviewed Jeff Goldblum.
That was funny. We went down to LA and had a little bit of fun with him.
You did.
That was great
the
guy.
Same week Far Cry 5 came out.
That's right.
What a week.
What a week. But let's look forward, not back, shall
right,
we, Jeffrey?
So, yeah, so those are the games with gold. Like I said, Insane Robots, Jurassic World Evolution, Toy Story 3, and Castlevania Lords of Shadow, Mirror of Fate HD.
Woohoo!
You can find details on, really, you can some of them you'll be able to download in just a couple of days.
Yes.
The others you'll have to wait until mid-December. You know how it works.
Yeah.
Man of Medan gets a Friends Pass.
Have you heard about this?
I have. So if you... you can enjoy one playthrough of shared story mode for free with a friend that doesn't own the game, which is really cool.
But you can't. You only have one free pass to use, so make sure you find somebody who's going to commit to it.
Exactly. So if you've got the game, all owners of Man of Medan, you can download the Curator's Cut pre-order bonus now for free as well. Synthesis update has come to, as you're listening to this, No Man's Sky. So this is the next really big update since No Man's Sky Beyond. It is specifically focused on a bunch of like fan favorite features. It is a free update. Beyond was sort of the 2.0 update. And this is this really, there's a lot of focus on multiplayer, creature writing, multiple multi-tools, terrain editor enhancements. There's a lot of stuff. So if you're, this is a game that has really just evolved in the years since it's come out. So a lot of the stuff is awaiting for you. And if you haven't picked up the game yet, you can get it on sale for only $29.99. I can credibly say there ain't no game like it.
Yep.
No Man's Sky.
That is. I was, it's funny. I had yesterday I had lunch with a good friend of ours, Laura.
She's great.
She sends her best. You were invited, but you had a conflict. You couldn't join us. But she's playing No Man's Sky, and she was going on and on about that.
Yeah, you can really lose yourself in that.
She was telling me you can name the planets, as we all know. Apparently, she got a bubble planet and named it Mr. Bubbly or Bubbly Planet or something. You can do whatever you want.
Yeah. Just hate when a planet gets typecast because of one thing, though.
Well,
people just really think of it that. They don't really talk about the rich cultural heritage of Bubbly Planet.
We need to keep our minds open.
You've got a thriving theater scene there.
Yeah.
Yeah. But just know, we'll just talk about the bubbles.
I hear it's fabulous.
It's wonderful. It's wonderful. I wanted to talk about a game that came out that while we were away, but looked really cool and has gotten some pretty good reviews, that was an ID at Xbox game called Narcos, Rise of the Cartels. Now, what kind of game, Narcos, based on the hit Netflix drama, what kind of game do you think that would be?
That's a good question. I don't know. What kind of game is it, Jeffrey?
It's a strategy RPG type of game, which it's not what you would expect.
Not an FPS.
No, it's not a shooter. Although there's apparently some sort of like real-time stuff that does happen. But it is a tactical turn-based game where you make decisions and there's some iconic moments from the show. Anyway, it looked really interesting. And it's not... when you hear of a tie-in between a TV franchise or something like that, or
game.
A movie, and normally you just clock out. This it seems really interesting, so worth taking a look at. I've seen some good reviews. Narcos: Rise of the Cartel. It's now available, and I also wanted to call out. And I guess this is another TV tie-in here. Do you know Justin Roiland? He's the creator of Rick and Morty.
Oh, yeah, of course. We chatted with him at PAX.
We did. He was in the panel right before us. Super nice guy. And his game, Squanch Games as well, but he's like a big part of that, of course, is Trover Saves the Universe. I ended up going to a panel on this game because it sort of caught my eye at PAX East last year. I can assure you, this is rated M. This is not for the kids, even though it looks like a cartoon game, but it's very funny. And it is available.
As they say in the industry, it's a little blue.
Sure.
Meaning
what industry
they're swearing.
Yeah, there's definitely some swearing. I don't know what. Anyway, coming out on December 2nd. So like just right after Thanksgiving at 4 p.m. for some reason. But let's just go with that.
They said that.
Yeah.
It's specifically at 4 p.m.
Okay. I'm looking at majornelson.com. It says 4 p.m.
Mark your diary.
It's not coming out at 4:20.
Right.
But that would have also probably been a good guess.
That's right.
$23.99 for that game. It looks very funny. I'll definitely be playing that alongside Halo Reach, which is coming out on December 3rd. That's another one with an interesting release time.
Yes.
So if you're excited about Halo Reach coming to
Did you
Master
play
Chief
that?
Collection, I played some of it because it came out when I was at Sony, and someone had fired a copy over to me. And I remember I played Firefight and I played a little bit of the campaign, but I wasn't able to finish it. Looking forward to making up for that now. I've been seeing the game being played on PC. You can actually, if you're an Xbox Game Pass member, go ahead and install it now. Do it. Hit the install button.
Yep.
Be ready.
And
that comes out on December 3rd, but it comes out at 10 a.m. on December 3rd. So if you're saying, oh, it's a Tuesday release, I'll just stay up late on Monday. Get your beauty sleep.
Please.
Save it.
Sleep
You'll
is
need
one,
it
sleep
because
is
come
important.
10 a.m. on Tuesday, you're going to be playing Halo Reach on Master
Among
Chief
other things.
Collection. I'm very excited for that one as well. Those items, my friend.
Those are the headlines.
That's the news. That's the headline.
Let's jump in the Wayback Machine and go back a couple weeks. Jeff and I and a lot of the Xbox team went over to London for XO19.
This is a great time.
We had a good time. Although you were on the road. You were down in Florida. You had some family stuff. So you and I never even chatted for a week before. And then we met... finally, when we got to London,
yeah,
it was a busy week, and you were working with some of the high profile creators that want to be part of Xbox.
Some good people out there, and I appreciate people making time, pulling them away from all the games.
This is
the best time to be playing games, and people came and they got to play games that they had never played before.
Yep.
Games that no one had played before.
Right.
Games that hadn't even been announced before.
Right, all of the above.
It was pretty great to say, hey, guess what? Obsidian's working on a new title, Grounded.
What?
Go ahead and play it now.
Right.
Like, what? You know, and there was a number of examples like that. Some really cool ID titles. I spent the game that I spent the most time with was a lengthy demo for Wasteland 3.
Which was, I remember that was our, like a back around the corner, right?
Yeah,
yeah, I remember.
Exactly.
I saw where it was on the show floor.
That's from our new partners at In Exile Games.
Yeah.
Coming out, I don't want to get the date wrong, but it's this spring sometime. It's been announced. I just don't have it right in front of me.
Right.
I'll grab it in a second. But it is really good. If you like an XCOM, like you do, you like a strategy game. Hey, if anything I said about the Narcos game sounds good, Wasteland 3 is going to be right up your alley. And it is quite good.
XO was
May 19th.
XO was a lot of fun. We don't need to talk too much because we that Sunday we did a podcast.
We did, but in case people didn't,
yeah, there's we didn't get to put the audio up, but so that's why if you listen to this, you can go back and watch it on my Mixer channel.
We had a live audience.
We had a live audience
right in front, as close,
just like you and I are sitting right here.
Like we're used to doing the PAX panel thing,
right?
But when we sat down, did it, and then people came in and sat on the front row. I was like, oh, this must be what being a teacher is like.
It was intimate.
Yes,
it was an intimate setting.
And I have new respect for teachers.
But we had a lot of fun there. You know, the Microsoft store in London, right there in Oxford Circus,
beautiful store,
beautiful. You hadn't been prior to our trip to London.
We did a whole tour, and they showed us all of the the historical parts of it. It's an amazing building. Highly recommend you visit and then do the simulator where you can get into the McLaren Senna, which is powered by Xbox.
Right, right. Which is it is.
That one is.
That one is, you should say. So we go back and watch that show if you want to see Jeff and I. And then we also talked about Grounded for like 20 minutes, the new game coming from our friends at Obsidian. You're looking for something. I see you staring in your console.
I am looking at something, but now you were saying Grounded?
Yeah, I'm just saying we talked a lot about Grounded. If you want to learn about the game more than you probably know, go watch the trailer and go watch it. We had a Q&A session. You know, we had a virtual Q&A. We had in-house Q&A. We had everybody Q&A. We were queuing and A-ing.
We were. And it was nice having the team there.
Yes.
It's amazing that, when you think of Obsidian, it's a big studio. They have multiple teams. Yeah. They're able to work on multiple things. And it's like a subgroup of, like 13-ish people.
Quite a few people, yeah.
Yeah, really cool.
When you worked at Sony, you didn't have any studios near you down in San Francisco, did you? Like any of your first parties?
No. Yeah. A lot of the, like, if you ever remember 989 Studios,
yeah,
they made like Game Breaker Football,
right,
and NBA Shootout, I want to say. That was all made there, but that was all like in the 90s, well before I worked there. And so by the time I got there, you worked with a lot of the producers, so I would always go down to like
the reason Santa I ask is because when we at Xbox, back in the day when Xbox owned Bungie, they were in the next building. And I went over there quite frequently. Yeah. And I just remember going in there. It was always my mental image, and I think you and I have talked about this, is a good studio size is like 100 or 150. And I, to me, that's kind of like what I always remember, a solid game being made. And now there are hundreds of people around the world. It's
one person. Like one person can make an amazing game like Stardew Valley or something like that.
Right.
So it's really, the shackles are off, and I think it's just, a bigger studio can do certain things that a smaller studio can't. But it is cool having those teams so close by. I'm over at Turn 10 from time to time.
Yeah, we still have that here. We've got
343.
Turn 10, 343, the Minecraft group.
That's one of my favorite parts about working here. It's just we're so close. Even the teams that make controllers or the teams that...
Well, I thought it was this. What?
Well,
I thought this was the favorite part.
Of course. And Xbox is Major Nelson.
And me tweeting out real time your conversations.
One of the things that they didn't, wasn't in the job description, and didn't go under benefits, and yet all the same. What else are you playing? Pick up anything new this week?
No, I haven't picked up anything at all new. I've been playing some xCloud stuff, just going back to check out my xCloud library, which is great. I know you're doing the same thing. I really haven't, I just haven't had a chance to play anything new because, when we came back from London, we had to do that. I will tell you this though, I did get my Stadia Founders Edition.
I did too.
Yeah, so
that's what I was teeing you up for.
Yeah,
there.
So we got that. So, but you asked about playing something new.
I'll drink my tea.
So I've been playing old games and checking it out. But yeah, so that's everyone asked me what I thought about that, and you can just go do an internet search, and you'll see a variety of opines.
Also picked up, you didn't ask, but I'm just going to tell you, Pokemon Sword, which is really cool. We have friends that work at the Pokemon company.
We do.
Shout out to E. I wonder if he still listens.
He does. Oh. I know Laura. In fact, Laura was really lighting me up yesterday at lunch. She's like, "You and Jeff hadn't done a podcast in a month. You need to get in there."
Oh my god!
Like, she listens religiously. So bless
her.
Laura.
I miss her.
Yeah.
Yeah. So our good friends at the Pokemon Company. This is the biggest. You don't care. You're looking at me like I
no. You love your Pokemon.
I love my Pokemon.
It's funny.
I went
into the local grocery store, the Safeway, which is a West Coast chain. I think it's Midwest and West. I went into the Safeway near my house, and they had a Pokemon vending machine.
Yeah, they have these really big,
I'm like,
Pokemon,
what is that?
Centers. They sell the car. There's,
I mean, I know
like,
what it is.
Like,
but
every other year, there's like a big resurgence. Like at my kid's school, all of a sudden, everyone's playing Pokemon again.
Well, it's the reason I kind of stopped and looked at it. I don't really play Pokemon, but you know, when I was growing up in Connecticut, and maybe there is now, there was never a nerd culture. I was so far out, and the fact of having something like a Pokemon vending machine in your local grocery store, that just
it is a golden age to be into like somewhat geeky. But it's not even geeky, it's mainstream stuff.
But,
like,
but what I'm saying is that we live in an area here in Seattle which embraces the future.
Sure, I agree with you on that. But I also just don't think I don't think it's restricted to, you know, Seattle or big cities. I think that, you know, video games are mainstream. All the stuff we grew up that was kind of a little bit niche is very much mainstream now and fun and cool, and I love it.
Yeah.
Like,
well, that's why I like it when I want to go home back to Connecticut, to my small hometown, and go, well, let's see what it's really, is it still the same? I don't know, you know, what's the computer lab like, you know, which was just so decrepit back in my day, you know, in the dark ages.
Yes, back in the 8-bit era.
All right, that's our walk down memory lane.
Anyway, Pokemon Sword, really cool. My starter's Grookey.
How do you play?
I catch them all.
What devices do you play on? That's what I'm
saying. Oh, it's a Switch.
Okay.
I usually do it in handheld, but because it's the first, not counting Let's Go Pikachu last year, it's like the first one I can really play on my big screen. And then, but I just prefer to play my Switch on the go, because when I'm at home in front of that big screen.
Because a lot of people I know don't play it on the go. They want to play it with the pro controller in front of
it. And that's fair. Right. You know, whatever works for you.
Right.
But, you know, we travel a lot.
Let's see. We talked Xbox. We touched a little bit on PlayStation. You're working there. We talked Stadia. We talked Nintendo.
We're gamers.
And games.
We play everything.
Yeah, exactly.
Is what I do.
Likewise.
Yeah. So.
I gotta start Outer Worlds on my PC.
Oh, for sure, man.
Right.
Get those achievements again.
Right.
I want to play. I was reading. You can. About speedrunners playing that game.
Yeah.
There's a speedrunner who beat the game in like 12 minutes somehow.
How?
Apparently the key to speedrunning that game is to be dumb as possible.
Right.
Because when you reduce your intelligence stat,
it opens up
new options.
Right.
But apparently some of them allow you to like launch Groundbreaker into the sun.
Right.
And just do a lot of like, or not Groundbreaker, but I guess the hope vessel that you're supposed to save everyone. Well, apparently you can just
spoiler
do that. Anyway.
See, now you just spoiled it.
That was like, that's the first 2 minutes of the game. Anyway. So, yeah. I want to play a second run through as possible.
I have Red Dead on my PC. My friend who works at Rockstar. Sent that over to me.
I bet that looks pretty good.
They had some launch optimization issues, but it's getting better. So, that's the good news. But it just looks so good on my big 4K screen. And
I've been thinking about going back to GTA 5. I don't know when I'm going to
We had a great time in that game. Yeah. You and I never played that, but we had some friends that we played that. And that's just such a great sandbox.
Yeah.
Is it on sale?
I can credibly look that up if you give me like a minute.
But yeah, so GTA was, I mean, that game just is the game that keeps getting updated, and we had a lot of fun with that, and the characters are great and so good. So Jeff is now pulling up the sale post right now.
There's so many games here. I'm actually having to sort through. Ooh, I might have guessed right. Almost there. Yes.
Yeah.
Grand Theft Auto 5, 67% off.
What?
That's two-thirds off.
Little disappointed, Rockstar. You didn't go for the 69% off.
Yeah, that's if you have Xbox Live Gold, and if you don't, you're probably not listening to the show, but it's still a healthy 60% off. There's also the premium online. There's actually like six different versions of the game.
Yeah.
All of them are on sale.
SKUs, as they call them.
Significantly on sale. And that is it. Right now, $11.99 for GTA 5.
Just the base.
Just the base game.
$11.99. You will get way more than $11.99 value out of that. I think that's guarantee
very,
that.
Very safe to say.
Yeah.
Also, Watch Dogs 2, $12.49. I really like that game.
That's a good game.
And I'm looking forward to Watch Dogs.
In London.
It's when does that come out?
Comes out next year sometime.
Next year sometime, yeah.
Jeff and I are going to be headed down to Los Angeles for the Game Awards.
Yeah, it's always a fun time.
Or as we affectionately call them on this show.
The Golden Keeleys.
The Golden Keeleys. So we're going to have Jeff Keighley and they're going to be doing that. So
be interesting to see. Have you voted? You can actually vote directly within your browser.
Yes.
And your vote counts.
Where do you do that? Because I remember I tweeted that out.
I think if you go to Google and you type in just the Game Awards, you can vote right in there. There's a number of categories that are going to be of interest, I think, to people who listen to the show. You can vote for there's best Xbox game. Gears of War shows up in a couple of different places.
Right.
The Outer Worlds shows up. In fact, I think the Outer Worlds is a nominee for Game of the Year, and it got my vote. There was a couple really tough votes in terms of
tough for you,
like who was my favorite character, best performance.
Right.
That was a tough one. I think I did give it to Parvati. Ashley Birch was Parvati in Outer Worlds, and it was a great performance. But there were some really good ones, and I actually had to sit there and think about it for quite some
time. Our good friend Laura Bailey for Gears 5.
Yeah, that it was between.
They're up against Mads Mikkelsen for Death Stranding.
Well, I haven't played that yet.
Or as the internet has called it, Jeff Stranding.
Why would they say such a thing?
I don't know. The internet.
You all right?
I'm great.
It's almost Thanksgiving. What are you having?
What am I? We've got...
How traditional do you go?
We have traditional turkey and, you know,
And what are the twists? I feel like every family has a bit of a twist, you know? But then again, knowing your wife, this is going to look right out of like a, you know...
Norman Rockwell.
Mashed potatoes and
perfectly
stuffing.
Perfectly coiffed.
Oh, it's gonna there'll be the turkey that has like those little chef hats on the end of the drumsticks for some reason.
Because why not?
It's gonna and it will be served under a metal dish, you know, the your turkey, sir.
We have a traditional. I think that
seems about right.
That seems about right because we like to do this. You know, growing up in Connecticut, we had quite the traditional. I mean, we don't do anything special. Her mashed potatoes are always quite excellent. So
a lot of butter. That's the secret there.
Well, yeah, a lot of butter. She made some that were terrible. She put them in the Vitamix.
Oh, apparently I was reading about this. You would think putting them in a blender or like a KitchenAid mixer or something like that would be the best way. And apparently that over mixes them.
Yeah, that's what happened. They
and
were like
they're
glue.
They're not fluffy.
They
it were makes like them glue. Really dense. I made that same mistake last year.
We have cranberry salsa.
Cranberry salsa?
Yeah, I believe
that's non-traditional.
I think that's what we've got. So I don't know. I'm looking. I'm trying to see if she... I know she sent it to me. I'm making
cranberries this year.
Yeah, I'll have to find out what it is. But she's doing some pretty. She always does some great stuff. My wife enjoys it. So.
See, I'm gonna confess to you, my favorite Thanksgiving tradition since I moved to Seattle is going through the neighborhood and surreptitiously borrowing sprigs of rosemary. Rosemary grows wild in Seattle.
Right,
it's all over the place. And there's a house which is currently up for sale down the street from me that has like the best rosemary bush, and I'm like, I'll just take just a couple of leaves.
I think she's gonna make some hummingbird cake. Four layers of cinnamon spice packed with bananas, pineapple, and pecans with browned butter panoush icing.
Panoush?
I have this exact reaction because my wife, family was from, I believe, Canada, and. It's panoush was a fudge.
Wait, you think your wife is from Canada?
No, she is from Canada, but she always likes to push panoush fudge on me, which I just...
It's too sweet.
It's way too sweet, yeah.
Well, that's it. See, there you go. That's like the turducken of cakes is what that sounds like.
It's everything.
We should get a turducken.
Next year?
Next year, let's do a turducken.
Well, wait a minute. You have quite a few collection of folks coming to your house.
Sure, I got some friends from Turn 10, some friends from...
Are they family or strays?
They're all strays.
Okay.
Because I'm not traveling across the country on Thanksgiving, and neither are they.
Wow,
and I don't
by
blame
the way,
them.
We're recording this a couple days before. It looks like they're going to get some snow everywhere.
Because that's what happens every year.
Yeah,
and
surprise!
That's not going to be me
surprise!
In a layover in Detroit. Not happening.
I did that.
I've done that too.
It's not fun.
No, it was for me, it was Raleigh.
Nothing
Durham.
Against Detroit, just nobody wants to be on a layover.
You're right, exactly. I hear it's a nice airport.
It's lovely.
Yeah, it's coming back. So, yeah, everyone's coming over. We'll have a good gaming group. I think most of the people coming over are part of the gaming industry. Mm-hmm. We'll probably be rolling some couch co-op, maybe some gang beasts.
Yes.
Our good friends at Double Fine. That's always a fun
game. Is that on Game Pass?
It is not, but it is a relatively inexpensive title.
Right, right. That was their indie funded one, right?
They've had a couple. Yeah. I don't know the details. All I know is it's a bunch of rag dolls that slap each other, and that's fun. That's fun. Also, classic
holiday fun.
Indeed. Well, I'm sure we'll play some Overcooked if we feel like yelling at each other. And then Lovers in a Dangerous Space Time. One of the earliest
titles,
but still one of the very best cult.
I do remember that one.
Good for four people.
Lovely.
Yeah. And we'll play some Apex over the weekend.
Yeah, we haven't played in a while. They've got a new event coming next week, I believe.
They
up the level cap. Yeah, I retweeted it yesterday.
Nice.
So they've got some stuff going on. I'm all respawn all the time between Jedi and Apex.
They only make hits.
They're on fire.
They're four
you know
for four.
What? You know
Titanfall
what?
1 and 2, Apex, and Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order.
You're not wrong.
I love all of these games.
As they say, you're not wrong.
No. Not that I'm right, per se, but I'm definitely not wrong. Anyway, well, I'm going to give thanks for all these great games.
Yeah.
That's what I'm thankful for. We have so much, and the time to play them now over Thanksgiving.
I'm going to just give thanks. Are we giving thanks? Is that what we're doing?
I guess we segued into that.
Yeah, I guess I'll give thanks for, you know, you giving me bountiful information to tweet out about coffee.
I'm glad to be fodder. And, of course, to your fans who listen to...
Our fans.
Sure. Who listen to the show.
And watched Inside Xbox.
Yeah.
So, can I tell you, I mean, we're just about ready to wrap up here, but can I give you a little bit of a behind-the-scenes action? Little story from behind
the scenes. Let's hear it. I love hearing it.
You know, if you watch Inside Xbox, there was a segment that they added at the last minute for Ricari, who was hosting it with me, and I were going to talk about a bunch of the deals for the holiday. And so we didn't really have time to look at the script, and it just came up in the teleprompter, but the teleprompter was partially blocked. So if you look at, did I show you the image?
You did, actually. Okay. Yes.
So it was a difficult read. So if you go back and watch that segment, it's you're not finding it, are you? Please no.
I'm not. I'm just looking through our notes. And what episode did you say this was? Did you say 644?
Yeah.
Because the Mixer Show was 644.
Mixers. Oh, was it? So this is 644B.
Well done. Well done. You're still not wrong. You're not wrong.
That's right. Well, that
Well, it's funny because like the prompter is 1970s technology.
And I have been working in the industry for a long time, and you and I have been working together for a long time. What do I always say? It's always the prompter.
It always is. It's usually not the operator's fault. For some reason.
The software, the computer, the video connection.
And there is no... Like, if one of the cameras goes down, you just turn towards another camera.
Right.
You know, if one of the mics is, they flip the mic, they're able to do stuff like that. If the prompter goes down,
you're
off the rails.
Yeah, you're done. You're like,
what was
okay.
I saying again?
Yeah.
Because we're not always, you know, you don't always have cards in your hand.
Something San Diego.
Exactly. Exactly.
So... All right,
you're a professional.
We're going to wrap it up here because we appreciate you giving us
well overstayed our welcome.
45 minutes of your day or night or weekend or morning, whatever it is. So have a great time. I hope if you're celebrating a holiday, enjoy that. We've got a lot going on for Christmas. We're going to work on a Mixer show. Going to get back into the studio for our little
an end of year. We'll talk about our games of the year.
Talk about the games, your best, your favorite games, your favorite moments.
Can we give some things away?
You know that I'll go. We're going to clean out the closet.
Oh, I love it.
We got some good stuff in the closet to give away. So we got a lot of stuff going on. But right now, we got to get ready for our U.S. Thanksgiving. So on behalf of everybody here at Xbox, have a great Thanksgiving or have a great weekend. Have a great week, whatever you're doing. Jeff, you have anything you want to say?
Yeah, we're going to be playing tons of games this week. So jump in. If you see us playing Apex or something like that, just jump into the team.
That's right.
And don't quit if you're down.
Right.
I will res you.
Yeah, Jeff will.
That's my pet peeve. Yeah, don't do it.
Don't do it. So
I'm coming for you.
At Jeff Rubenstein on Twitter is where the complaint desk is.
Always.
Or the grievance desk.
The air your grievances at Jeff Rubenstein.
All right. I'm Larry here at Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.